Hope you've had a good weekend, you know, when everything is good for you and all that jazz. And we're just gonna jump right into it. So this week, the point of study, we're gonna title it Along the Way, right? Along the Way. And remember, we should have been reading from Acts chapter 8, verses 26 through 40. Okay? Heavenly Father, I ask that you just sit with us, Lord. Reveal, open eyes, Holy Spirit, provide clarity. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so the who's that we are looking at this week, we are looking at Philip. The who's, right? So the who's of the scenario that we're looking at. Philip, an angel of the Lord, a eunuch, the Holy Spirit, and the prophet Isaiah. The what are we looking at is an encounter, a conversion of belief, a baptism, sharing the gospel, and spreading the gospel. All right. When, in the midst of the persecution of followers of the way, during the spreading of the good news, during a time of fleeing, after Philip received instructions from the Holy Spirit, after the eunuch was returning from worship, in the middle of the eunuch reading words from prophet Isaiah, and before Philip was caught away. Where did a majority of this take place? On the desert road between Jerusalem and Gaza, right? Between where I was and where I want to be. Between who I am and who I am becoming. Or in between who I was and who I am now, right? And it also happened in and alongside the eunuch's carriage, which translated to in my current moment, right? In my current season, in this very thing that's carrying me to my future, to the next thing that's going to house me, right? It's taking place in this very time, right? This situation, this moment of revelation, this moment of clarity, right? This situation that is like, seems to be causing chaos, right? It happened in the midst of that vehicle, okay? And why did it happen? Because the Holy Spirit said so. Okay? This was an easy one. Because the Holy Spirit said so. It was orchestrated by God and followed through by the Holy Spirit. Okay? The Holy Spirit gave instructions. And we have the rest of the situation happening. All right? How did it happen? Same answer. Same answer as the why. Okay? By direction and order of the Holy Spirit. Okay? The focal point is you, the reader, Philip, and the eunuch, with emphasis on Philip. And we're going to get to why Holy Spirit is wanting me to put a little more emphasis on Philip. Okay? So we're going to get to the coincidences that we're looking at in this situation. So the first coincidence A, after Philip fled from his current situation, he was given a new location, he was given a new destination. And some of the things that the Holy Spirit was saying was that this is an example of Philip using his pain for purpose, right? How is it that in a time of persecution, you continue moving in the very thing that they are trying to kill, right? So this was right after Saul went wild for real and started persecuting followers of the way, right? So it is this very thing. It is this very thing that Philip is choosing to continue in that the enemy is trying to kill. My God. And that's a word for somebody. The very thing that people are coming up against in this season, the very thing that the enemy is trying to kill, to stop from manifesting itself into full fruition, right? That very thing God is asking you. Holy Spirit is leading you to continue in that very thing. Yep, this was a time when the way was under attack, one of its greatest attacks, mind you. Like this is one of the most talked about times where followers of the way were persecuted, right? This is one of the biggest, right? Oh, you trying to kill my business? Well, let me just continue in that. Oh, you after my marriage? Let me just go ahead and continue to fight for that, because I'm telling you now that the very thing, right? And I know this is going to be a confirmation for a lot of you guys in this season, is the very thing that is under attack, whether it be a union, whether it be a new relationship, whether it be a friendship, a business venture, right? A belief, right? You got some ventures going on right in the background, and it seems like they are coming up against persecution, and it just seems like it's attack after attack after attack after attack. This is the very thing that the Holy Spirit is asking you to continue in. This is the very thing that the Lord wants to see if you have strength to continue fighting in, right? To continue moving in. And it's, you know, and I had to learn this myself, right? I had to learn the difference between which weapons to use, you know, in the season, right? Do I fight with the word? Do I fight with, you know what I'm saying, prayer? So it was the Holy Spirit to help with that. But definitely the very thing that is being persecuted and, you know, facing the most adversity in this season, that is the very thing that the Lord wants to know. Will you continue moving in? Okay. Let's see. Coincidence B. After Philip follows specific instructions, he's met with the perfect opportunity. Okay. And this goes hand in hand with coincidence C. So I'm going to read that, and then we're going to talk about it a little bit. Okay. And coincidence C. In the midst of the eunuch returning from worship, he's met with a helpmate. Okay? So, Philip is given specific instructions, right? And based on what how I read it and, you know, everything, he was given partial instructions. Go here. Go alongside. Let's look at it. As for Philip, an angel of the Lord said to him, "Go south down the desert road that runs from Jerusalem to Gaza." So he did, and he met the treasurer of Ethiopia, a eunuch of great authority under the queen of Ethiopia. Okay, fast forward. Yep, the Holy Spirit said to Philip, "Go over and walk along beside the carriage." So it was very specific. It was very specific, and do this, and he never received the next instruction until he completed the first one. And so that is a word for a lot of you all. You wondering why God has been quiet in this season, and you're wondering why you're not hearing him, or you feel like he's not saying anything, and it's because you haven't completed the first instruction that he has given you. And I know, hold on y'all, excuse me, gotta fix my clothes a little bit. I know, because in this past season of my life, he was very strategic with me. He would not, okay, I'm talking about, he would not give nothing new until I completed the very thing that he had asked me to do previously. And how I know I would complete something? Because I hear something new, you know? And that is a lot of y'all stories. Y'all wondering why God ain't talking to you. So you feeling like, I can just be all willy-nilly, go back to doing what I do, you know what I'm saying? Since he ain't saying nothing, I might as well go ahead and do this. Since he ain't saying anything, why continue anyway? And it's because somewhere along the line, you either forgot about this instruction, you don't care about the instruction, or you just being disobedient and you're just not listening. And you're not going to get a new answer. You're not going to get another answer. You're not going to get a new instruction until you do what he has asked you to do already, right? And then you will essentially meet the perfect opportunity, right? Which ties hand in hand with the coincidence C, with the eunuch returning from worship, and he's met with the helpmate. So, right? This is also a lot of people's stories, right? So you're in the midst of worshiping, right? And you're developing this new habit for the Lord, right? And it doesn't necessarily just have to be for him, right? But you're developing these new habits for yourself. And you're in the midst of not really knowing. Like, it feels new. It feels kind of right. But it doesn't necessarily quite fit the way that you want it to. And, you know, you want to go forward in it. And you want to move forward in it. And you want to make sure that you're doing it how you're supposed to be doing it, right? And you want to make sure that you're listening correctly. And all you have all of these questions of the hows and the whys. And the, is this right? Is this okay? And you're saying, like, Lord, just please send me help. God, please send someone who will make this a little easier for me, right? Your help is coming. Your help is on the way. Okay? But this is a moment, though, and it's so important that you just not ask for help from just anyone, right? It's real important when you're in those times of doing something and you're not really knowing why you're doing, because I'm going to be honest with y'all. A lot of the times when God asks you to do something, when he instructs you to do something, it is not going to make sense in the moment that he asks you to do it. And so by nature, it's almost a knee-jerk reaction, right? You're going to want to get direction from somebody else. You're going to want to get that clarity from somebody else, right? Please confirm for me that I'm not crazy, right? Please confirm for me, you know what I'm saying, that am I understanding it right? Am I hearing it right? Your help is on the way. I just want to bring you confirmation today that your help is on the way. But this is a moment where you have to choose to be still and wait on him to send it. And you're not going to seek for it other than him. It'll come. It may not come in the time frame that you want it, right? Because he don't operate on our timetables. And that is another lesson that he has had to get down deep in me. I'm talking about he done grew some thick roots, right, for me with patience. Right. And his timetables. Right. Not when Dynasty says, or not when Dynasty thinks something will happen, or not when Dynasty wants. Right. OK. Coincidence D. After Philip was obedient. And this is where and why we put the emphasis on Philip. Right. Specifically giving him more of the focus in this situation. After Philip was obedient, both of the individuals, the eunuch and Philip, my little notes, experienced the perfect encounter together, right? So it wasn't until, so that's not to say that each of them didn't have their own journey individually, right? Because both in their moments coming up to this situation, they both had an encounter with the Holy Spirit, right? Philip was given instructions, and the eunuch, he had a moment of worship. He had a moment of, he was living through, and he was looking for some answers and everything. And it wasn't until they met up together that the eunuch was baptized. And this is the perfect opportunity, right? And so this is for a lot of y'all this season. So to listen up, emphasis on Philip here, because had Philip ignored what the Holy Spirit was asking him to do, the eunuch would have never been baptized and would have just rolled by the water. Maybe never understanding its significance, right? And even in what he was reading, right? Had Philip just completely ignored what the Holy Spirit told him to do, the eunuch could have just rolled along, never been baptized, never really understanding what he was reading, right? Never really getting a full grasp of the moment of worship that he had, all because Philip ignored what the Holy Spirit asked him to do, okay? So specifically speaking to those who feel that they have been given partial instructions, or you've been told to go someplace, or you are getting ready to receive partial instructions, and this is God telling you to go with it. This next thing can't move without you in it, and it will be along the way. Okay, so like I said, it will come in motion. It will come in motion. It'll come as you go. As you go, it's just gonna flow. And it made my words, but you know what I'm saying? I'm stealing them, because again, that was something that was instilled in me in this season, right? But whatever this next thing that is getting ready to happen in your life, it cannot happen. Hey, it cannot happen without you following instructions of the Holy Spirit. So one, you have to be obedient. It's not gonna come by disobedience, okay? Two, you're gonna need to be there. You're gonna need to be there. You're gonna need to be there, and you're gonna need to sit and wait on the Holy Spirit to give you these instructions. Now I know, especially in this popcorn tradition, a culture, right now, time that we in, we have a hard time waiting. we all seem to have a hard time waiting. But in this particular season, at this particular point in your journey, God was real specific. He was real specific. Whatever partial instructions that you have received already, or that you are getting ready to receive, God said, go with it. He's telling you right now, this is your confirmation to go with it. And to the eunuchs who find yourselves in the midst of just doing things and you have no idea why you're doing it, your help is on the way. Clarity is arriving at your doorstep. This next thing, this next thing that's getting ready to happen will require the both of you. It will require both the Philips and the eunuchs. This won't be something that can be accomplished alone. talking to the Phillips and the eunuchs of the situation, right? It's big. It's big. It's big. And like I said, you'll know that this word is for you because it'll be confirmation. But God is saying to the eunuchs, your help is on the way. Be patient. Your help is on the way. And to the Phillips, follow the instructions. Follow the partial instructions. The eunuch needs you. Okay? The eunuch is waiting on you. This situation is waiting on you. This business is waiting on you. This next idea is waiting on you. This blow up is waiting on you. This financial breakthrough is waiting on you. It's waiting on you to get there, to follow these instructions. My God. And it cannot happen without, both of you are important. Both of you are important. Made plain. Your level of understanding is about to skyrocket. You'll step into a level of understanding like never before. My God. And this was a prophecy that he had gave me while I was studying for this word. So, you know what I'm saying? Listen up. Open up them ears. You know what I'm saying? Fine tune. Got to clean it out. Listen. Because he stopped everything that I was doing. He stopped me in the midst of studying and had me write this down. Made plain, your level of understanding is about to skyrocket. You'll step into a level of understanding like never before. He said, because you asked and have completed the steps I've told you to complete, you shall receive it in his name. Okay, you shall receive that in his name. Amen. I stand in agreement and affirmation with that. Bless you, whoever you are, whoever that was for. My God, bless you for your obedience, okay? Because it's making me real warm. That's a word from somebody right now, right now. Okay. Coincidence E, after the mission was completed, which after the eunuch was baptized and his conversion of belief was fully completed, right? He had a moment of worship. You know what I'm saying? The gospel was preached to him. He was baptized. That completed his conversion. Boom, it's completed. They never saw each other again after that moment. Okay. They never saw each other after that moment. And so God specifically highlighted this for someone specific now, okay? And I know I have put out this disclaimer before, right? Because here's the thing with the times that we're living in, right? Because God is beginning to move with the times. Well, he's always moved with the times, right? But because we are starting to evangelize and minister and preach and teach all of these things outside of the church, you have to understand something as far as the prophetic goes, right? Because usually anytime a prophetic word would come, it would be to a specific person, right? At a specific time, specific date, specific place, right? And so that still happens a lot of times in the churches. But with the prophetic moving to the internet, right, that doesn't make what the prophet says disingenuous, right? It doesn't make it not true, okay? It's just that but because the channel is so wide, right? And God is now able to reach more people this way, right? But it's so important that you understand that when specific words like these happen, they specific for a reason. So don't snatch something, you know what I'm saying, that you ain't ready to carry the weight for, because a lot of times these words carry weight. So I'm nervous going ahead and releasing this, because this is the first time he's given me a specific name for someone. Well, not the first time, but the first time he didn't tell me to release it on video. Okay. So this, listen up. Okay. This is for someone specific. I don't know who you are, but I'm hearing the name James S. Okay. James S. This is specifically for you. God wants you to know that you are about to experience a string of encounters back to back that is going to test your faith, will, and endurance. The encounters you are about to have, you won't see these individuals, but only the one time. It's important that you listen to the instructions given, as each encounter will be different, but each encounter is crucial to your future. A string line of four of them. So you are getting ready to encounter four situations that is going to streamline you and propel you into your future. If you handle them the way that the Holy Spirit is asking you to handle them, if you handle them correctly, which correctly is just being in right standing with God and doing it how he is asking you to, regardless of how it makes sense to you, regardless of how it makes sense to you. Okay. So that's for you. get ready, because these encounters are about to happen back to back to back. I mean, one's going to happen, you're going to complete it, and you're going to walk into another situation. Okay? Okay. And so this is a note off of the coincidence. After the mission was completed, they never saw each other again, right? And this is the note that the Holy Spirit had me write down aside from that prophecy, right? Most of the time when we're ending relationship or dealing with something good, we'll want to extend its lifespan, trying to hold on to it. God is saying in this moment, after the good thing, after the good experience, let it go to grow onto something great. Had the Spirit not taken Philip away, who knows how long they would have continued on. It's possible the eunuch could have had more questions and Philip would have been ready and glad to share them with answers. Both received what they needed to continue on from that season. Okay, so God is just saying to a lot of people that if you have experienced a good thing in a season, right? You have came across something that has been good to you in this season and has treated you well. But you have been feeling here lately that it may be ending, right? The time of it still living in your life is coming to a close and you weren't necessarily sure, right? There was a little confusion there. God is telling you that, you know, had you experienced something good and you're feeling like it's time to end it, then it's time. It's time. This is that confirmation right there that it's time to let it go, to grow onto something great, right? And that's not to say that it just has to end badly, right? It don't have to be one of them things, right? Because it has to end, you making it a negative situation, right? It can end just as good as it started, right? It should end as good as it started so it can be better for the next, right? And the next, you know, let's not tack a person, right? It could be a next situation or, you know, how whatever the next looks like for you, okay? Yep. But they both received what they needed. They both got what they came for from that moment. And they were sent on. They both went on, okay? And that's all I got for you today. I pray that that was an answer to some of y'all's questions. I pray that you got some revelation and I pray that it was a blessing for you. Okay. So next week, as I told y'all at the beginning of this session, we have a break week next week, but that doesn't mean that you don't need to come back. Right. So that means for next week, you don't need to read. There is no reading requirement. Right. But make sure you come back because we do have a word for you, y'all. And I feel like this word is going to free a lot of people. I feel like this word is going to provide clarity and peace to some insanity that you have been feeling with this last season that you have been going through, right? I am excited for the word to be released. Actually, I am excited for it. A little nervous, like always, but I am excited for the word to go forth. So y'all need to make sure y'all come back. And I got a feeling that this word is gonna be for more than just you. So make sure y'all share out this word next week. Make sure y'all send it to at least 3 to 5 people you know who need to hear it. Cause it's gonna be one of them. It's gonna be like that, okay? So next week, no reading, no point of study, just show up and we're gonna have a word for you, okay? But the following week, the week of the 30th, okay? Your reading material for that week will be Acts chapter 14 through Luke 11. And the point of study is Acts 9, 10 through 19, okay? And I'm gonna make sure to put a little recap at the end of the video just so we know that, yep. And then your spiritual nuggets for the week, let me step to the side. Your spiritual nuggets for the week are 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verses 20 through 24, 1 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9, 11, and 12. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 33 through 34. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verses 13 through 14. And Romans chapter 3, verses 10 through 18. And those are your spiritual nuggets for the week. How have these sidebars been blessing you? I pray that they have been sustaining you and giving you some fruit throughout the week that you could eat on until you get back here with us on Sundays, or till you get into communion with the body wherever you're worshiping at. I pray that you are getting everything that you are meant to get coming to this channel. My God, I never want to send y'all out malnourished. I never want to send y'all out incomplete or slighted or none of that. I always want to make sure I send y'all out with love, peace, and blessings. Why? Because those are the best things in life. The best things in life are free always. So make sure y'all come back. Y'all ain't even got to read. So y'all really need to be in class. Make sure y'all back. But that's it. I love you all. I'll see y'all soon. Have a good one. Have a good one. I'm about to get out of here. And I don't know. See what's going on popping with today. But I see y'all. Love y'all.